Toronto, you just said you're too old for this, but you've done it 2 weeks in a row now. First against the Celtics, 3.1 seconds left. You guys take the first lead of the game off of your basket. Can you take me through those last two plays, forcing that 5 second and then getting that final basket?
I don't know. It was kind of crazy how we recovered that that possession out there. The guys did a great job denying everything, so they didn't have an outlet. And we got lucky because he hit me in the leg, I think, and the ball hit him back, and it was our possession. So things that happen in a basketball game. The good thing is that we kept fighting. We played badly for half of the game or more. But we were able to recover, to fight through it, and get to that last possession and finish it. But no, we shouldn't be proud of this game, but we should be learning because we did a lot of things wrong. We made too many mental mistakes, miscommunications, and hopefully we solve these problems and face forward.
Those last 4 minutes and 11 seconds, you held Dallas scoreless, went on a 13-0 run, and forced six turnovers. Yes, what sparked that run from you guys?
Well, in situations like that, it's easier to find the best out of you because you know you don't have a margin of error, that you is all or nothing. So that's when we got that aggressiveness and that juice. The thing is that we got to try to bring it from minute one or, you know, the 12th, the 18th. We got to be more consistent because if not, you know, today happened, but it's not going to happen every time. So we need to be more consistent and regardless of who was playing and who was not, we just got to fight harder from longer periods.
You talk about bringing that juice. Another complete game by you tonight, 12 points, 5 rebounds, 3 assists. Guys on the team say when you're playing hard, that inspires them to play hard as well. What does that mean to you to hear that from your teammates?
Of course, it's great. It's a great honor. It's a lot of pressure, too. When I don't bring it, we are messed up. No, seriously, not. The effort is contagious. So when we see Patty diving, or when three guys go pick somebody up, when the bench is all into it, we feed off that those situations. So we need the spark from everybody. So today we got it, maybe a little late, but we got it, and we gotta keep bringing it.
It's hard to believe you guys have completed the series with Dallas now. I saw them just last week. Are you sick of seeing them yet or what?
Yes, I actually are. And, you know, we lost. We played poorly there. And we really wanted to come here and play a good game. The fact that we played yesterday, that Kawhi, Tony, Kyle, Danny were not playing, we knew we were in a tough spot. But we knew we could get this win. We hoped to have played better, but we got it.
The team has been in a tough stretch of games recently, and another tough stretch, 5 games in 7 days. You have the Clippers coming in on Monday. What can you take away from not only maybe this game, but the last 3 games to continue to build off of?
We haven't been playing great in the last week. We were coming from a good week, and now we are kind of stumbling. We are trying to include Kawhi, but at the same time, we got a few guys that are struggling coming from injuries, and Danny with his groin. So the rotations are not quite there. We are not used to, or we don't know exactly what's going to come. And sometimes that messes up with our heads and with our confidence. So the most important thing now is to keep getting wins, keep getting guys healthy, and get back to our solid, steady Spurs rotation.
Well, Manu, congratulations on the win tonight. You're not too old. You still got it.
Thank you very much.